Yeah. Hi, Angel. How do you deal with dating as a single mom? Like, was there ever an instance that you really liked the guy, but he was hesitant about your son?
You know what's funny is people have a hard time believing he's my son. They think he's my boyfriend sometimes. Okay, so weird. Like, we'll go out and I'll chaperone him or something, and a guy wants to hit on me, but they think he's my boyfriend. So he kind of like blocks that for me sometimes. So that's one. It's difficult when you're young. You still look young. You were young. I was a young mom. I had him when I was 17. So I look young, and he looks like a man because he's a man now. You know, so we look almost like in the
In the same age
same age
bracket.
bracket. So one, men are afraid of my son because they either think he's with me or they're not good enough. And I find that a lot of men who aren't secure with themselves won't even try to approach me because one, I'm too confident, so they're scared of me. Two, then they get scared of my son because my son achieved something for himself. So now they compete with him. And he loves to give me gifts and, you know, he throws me surprise parties. So no one can really compete with that, you know? So it takes someone with really, really strong heart and confidence to really try to be in my life.
Too
Actually, I
many high
agree. Yeah,
self-assurance.
and the thing is, and the thing is, this is the thing too. I love that after I broke up with my ex-husband and other terrible relationships, I took the time to heal and not be in a relationship, not rebound, because I knew there was something wrong I was doing in the patterns of my relationship,
I
right?
agree.
And I needed to heal myself, and I got to the point where I was like embarrassed to go to the movie by myself. I was embarrassed to eat dinner by myself. But once you pass that and you get to a mental state that you're so comfortable and confident, you actually become happy alone. It's weird. Like, I found happiness being single.
Yeah.
And it's so powerful because now that I'm so happy being alone, anyone that comes into my life, doesn't have the power to shake me. Does that make sense? Like,
Yes, I know
it
what you
doesn't
mean.
rock me. If I get someone, great. If I don't, it's okay. You know what I
Yeah,
mean? And
yeah.
I had my kids. I know what it's like to be married. Like, I'm fine. And for me,
You're
I'm
fulfilled.
fulfilled. So a relationship should be a bonus, not a destination. So whoever enters my life now is just a bonus for me because I love my life, you know?
I have this theory about love. Like, you know how they always say that, you know, you need to find your perfect half, or you're half of something, and then you need to find the other half of you to fulfill you. And I always thought that was bullshit. Like, my theory is we're always whole. So you need to find someone who's whole as well. And then when you intersect, that's a Venn diagram, by the way. And that's my math
Yeah, I'm
geeky
like
ass talking out. But yeah, so love is.
math.
Oh, well, it wouldn't be pillow talk if we didn't inject like things like that. But,
Oh,
you know, and
intersect and then now inject.
Yeah, so let's inject ourselves in a way that's when you intersect with someone
God.
in very interesting ways, that's where the magic happens.
Yeah. No, it's so true. We receive the love we feel we deserve, you know, and we stand up for what we think is what we our standard. So if you're in a crappy relationship or you're going in the same circles, you need to ask yourself, what am I doing wrong? You know what I mean? And I totally believe that whoever's for you, meant for you, will find you but the thing is, you have to find yourself first.
And plus,
Fall in love with yourself first, and everything else will follow, you know?
I think the ones who are meant to stay will stay.
Oh, yeah,
You know,
totally.
like.
That's why I like scare them right at the first. Like, my kids scare them, I scare them, and if they stay, all right, I give you time of day.
If they're not completely sold on that idea of you, so it's a waste of
Oh,
time.
totally. Like,
So,
everyone
I
knows
mean.
I have kids. Everyone knows that I require something. I have like these. I like this, I like that. I'm sorry, I'm not gonna change for you. You know, I like my son is like this, my daughter's like that, you know. And the thing is, if I'm unfortunately, fortunately, I'm a good mom, which means I respect my children's feelings. So
that's true.
When someone enters my life, they're going to be part of my children. Like, I don't date to date. If I date someone, it's because I want to lead into something more. Because what's
exactly.
That's the point of dating.
Yeah.
Dating isn't because we're just trying to fill a loneliness. Dating is because you're scouting and you're auditioning people who's going to end up being with you, sana,
yeah.
For long term, right?
Long term, yeah.
So I need to be respectful to my kids and how they feel, and you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It can't just be someone I enter. I can't let someone enter,
yeah.
You know, my life every month, and you know what I mean? It's meaningful,
yeah.
To me. So I really value how my children look at whoever I'm with.
Before
so,
we get too deep into that, I want to dial it back to the question.
Yeah.
And I'm sure the fans of Tony would like to know how Tony is with your suitors. Like,
you know what? I haven't really introduced people into my life, but I have a funny story. I hope he's not watching. So when we went to a bar once, he's so cute because he sees me as a certain way, and I love that. I love my children look at me so highly. You know, we went to a bar once, and then you know people talk to me because they think I'm young. So young people, you know, young guys. You know, I'm sorry, the young boys love me. Anyway, so some guy was trying to buy me a drink, and he's like, hey, do you have a boyfriend? And I'm like, no, you know.
I like it with hair.
And the thing is, like, you know, girls don't want to buy their drinks. So I'm like, yeah, sure, buy me a drink, I don't care. So he's, like, going to buy me a drink. And my son, so I'm talking to him like this, right? I'm like, yeah, no. And the thing with showbiz in the Philippines, you have to be nice to everyone because you never know who you're gonna meet, right?
Mm-hmm.
So me, I don't like to taray anyone because you never know, right? So
yeah.
I'm just nice. I'm like, yeah, sure, whatever. And all of a sudden, here comes my son with his hand right here. Do not talk to my mom. I'm like, ooh. And then he's like, you don't deserve my mom. And then the guy goes, I thought you didn't have a boyfriend. I go, I don't. That's my son. So it's just so
funny.
What
did the guy do after?
He backed away slowly. I didn't get that drink, but it's okay. So,
Tony brought me the drink.
Was that
yeah.
Was that the only time he did it? Or he?
No, that was the only time. That was the only time. It's just cute because he's protective, but also he cares for me so much. And like I said, I don't want anyone to be in our life that isn't worthy of introducing, if that makes any sense. So he's really supportive. I always make sure he vets people, and because my children are a part of me. So I can't date someone that doesn't, you know, my children won't approve of, because that's what you hope for, is the end game, you know?